By the end of this video, you're going to have a much better understanding of what bubble workload is and how to think about it when you're developing a bubble app. My name is Seth. I'm the founder of No Code MBA, a no code education site teaching how to use apps like Bubble and also other no code tools like Webflow, Airtable, Zapier, and much more, taught by experts in the industry. Be sure to check out the link in our description to view all of our in-depth tutorials. Okay, so bubble workload. This is a topic that a lot of people have strong opinions about, and I'm just going to share my personal experience with bubble workload, my opinions. Other people might have different experiences and opinions about this based on the different apps that they're developing, but I'm just going to share my experience and to the best of my ability, give you my opinion on how you should think about workload. So workload on a high level is Bubble attempting to charge you for the usage of your app based on how much processing power and searches and essentially, you know, how much computer usage your app is taking up. So just as an example, if your app was just a single page with a form for people to enter their email and that was it, then that's really simple. The workload is going to be really small. But if your app is really complicated, let's say you're building a clone of Airbnb, for example, a whole marketplace app with a lot of workflows and logic and backend workflows and users on your site, then that's going to use up a lot more workload. So the idea on a high level there is that Bubble is going to charge you for things like page load, external API requests, fetching data, which is searching for data, for example, a few other things, but these are just kind of some of the example workloads in this sample app that I have. And you can see Bubble has in their logs section something called app metrics, which allows you to see workload over time. So this app I haven't really used very much. This is just an example app that I have. So the workload usage is really low. Something else to keep in mind is Bubble does give you, I believe it's 100,000 workload units per month for your development app. So when you're developing, you don't have to worry too much about going over that while you're just testing out your app and developing. One of the things that I think a lot of people have concern about with workload is that it's going to cause your app to be too expensive to be financially viable. Now, this isn't something that I have personally experienced. So just as an example, I run No Code MBA on Bubble. So everything after users log into No Code MBA is built on Bubble, the learning platform. There's thousands of members on No Code MBA. And I have not run into any issues where I'm going over my limits of workload. Now, if I did go over my limits, there are overage fees. There's also things that I could do on the app, I'm sure, to optimize my app. There are certain searches that might be taking a lot of workload. So kind of if it started to get a little bit more expensive than I would like, there are things that I could do to optimize my app. But I've never run into an issue where, you know, the amount of money that the business is making isn't more than enough to cover the cost of using Bubble, especially when I consider how much it would cost to hire a developer or kind of even how infeasible that would be and the benefits that I get to using Bubble. So that's just my personal opinion. I've also built other apps, which again, I haven't noticed any issues where the cost of workload is going to cause the business to be financially not viable. The reason for that is, you know, typically if you're building an app on Bubble, you're going to be charging users to use that app. And the amount of money that you're going to charge users is, in almost all cases that I've seen, more than enough to cover the Bubble workload cost. Now, are there certain apps, such as like a social media app, for example, where, you know, users might be using the app a lot, you might have lots of users, and you might not have a lot of revenue per user, where Bubble might not be viable in the long run? I think that is possible. Now, if that happens, I think that's a good problem to have. If, you know, you have so many users that it turns out that this is too expensive to run on Bubble, in that case, you can rebuild your app on another platform and you know you're going to be successful enough and have enough traction where it makes sense for you to invest and do that. It's also an area where I wouldn't be surprised if you reached out to the Bubble team and you had a really successful social media app that they wouldn't work with you to try and make it financially viable for you, because Bubble wants to have successful apps on their platform. So in the case that you do have that situation, I would definitely recommend reaching out to them and seeing what you can do. But again, at that point, it's a good problem to have because you have a successful app with a lot of users. So I think a lot of times people think about, what's going to happen when I am scaled up and I have, 100,000 users on my platform, when most, companies struggle to get 100 users on their app and actually using it. So it's something that I wouldn't worry too much about. I would just worry about using Bubble, building your app, doing it in the best way possible. In almost all cases, you're not going to have any issues with workload. And if there is a situation where you do have an issue, there are options that you can explore at that point. So that's my overall opinion on Bubble workload. I hope that this was kind of helpful and it gives you some things to think about. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. If there's anything that I missed, also please leave it in the comments. I'd love to learn from you about this topic. And be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get all of our future content right here. So thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.